Yo, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. In this video today, we're going to be doing an overview of the brand new multiplayer map, Beheaded. This is officially dropping tomorrow with Season 5 on Vanguard. It's available right now, along with all of the new weapons, which we'll also be taking a look at in this video today, through a private match. For some reason, they put the update out on the 23rd, and it allows you to play everything in private matches, even though it's not supposed to release till tomorrow. So just keep in mind, everything that we're going to be witnessing and doing in this video will be done in private matches. Bots will be in there. So the maps, I know for sure, will not play the same once real players actually get a hold of it. But Beheaded is by far one of the most detailed multiplayer maps I think that we've gotten so far through the Vanguard season. This one is definitely considered medium to maybe even on the larger side. The layout is kind of strange. It takes place in New York City. In the center, you have the head of Lady Liberty, which you're able to actually go up into and use as a line of sight across the map itself. There's also doors and different businesses that you can go through in order to navigate around to flank. The businesses can also provide ample cover to you against the enemy that can be found on the outside, found in the roadways. Now, the roadway has also been destroyed, which takes you down to a lower level subway station, and the subway can also be used to flank around enemies. Alternatively, you could just stay up in the streets and move forward with your assault. So this is a very interesting laid out map, not only because there's a lot of elevation to it, but also because there's a lot of areas that just seem unnecessary until you think about the relief of spawns. Like, there's alleyways with cutouts that just seem like they shouldn't be there, and then there's like back room alleyway areas, and it's just kind of like you can camp there. It's just strange. I feel like there's going to be a lot of camping taking place on this map in particular, at least for the first few hours of gameplay while people get their footing for the locations that they want to go. But overall, a very cool looking map, tons of detail, the lighting effects and the destruction look fantastic. And this is one of those maps that I'd really like to see a little bit more weather element to, like maybe rain. That would give really cool opportunities for ray tracing to be bouncing off the streets with the puddles and water running down into the lower end of the subway, giving you an opportunity to slide through that water down below. Would have been really cool, but unfortunately not a thing that's going to be happening here probably ever. Now, let's go ahead and move on over and talk a little bit about the weapons. There are going to be three different weapons that end up coming through for Season 5, at the launch at least. The first one I want to talk about is the EX1. This is a prototype energy rifle that actually has quite a bit of different attachments that you're able to select. These attachments are also futuristic, which gives a really cool look to the weapon overall. Not only that, but you're also able to convert this weapon into a couple different things. You can use it as an AR, you can use it as a sniper rifle with a built-up burst charge mechanism, you can use it as a three-round burst or even semi-automatic, and I think at its core, at its base, with 60 rounds to its magazine, this can go extremely well for people who are accurate. At longer range engagements, you're going to notice that the damage itself really isn't too crazy, but that's why there's a sniper mod to it. Burst firing gives you a one-shot capability as long as you're holding down the trigger in order to build up the burst. The longer you hold it, the more power you're going to do until eventually you'll be able to just get one-shot kills. One thing I did notice with that sniper mod, holding down the trigger and charging up that burst actually shows on the radar. So as long as you're holding that trigger, you will actually see that your weapon is showing as firing on the minimap. Don't know if this is just a bug and it only shows on the player end, or if this is going to mean you're going to be illuminated as a red dot the entire time you're charging up your shot. That would be a pretty interesting way to balance out this one-shot kill capable weapon if you were to use it. And it's really satisfying to get a one-hit kill, even if it is against bots. The burst fire isn't too bad. The semi-auto, I wasn't really a big fan of. And just using it as the regular assault rifle version was really, really fun. Each projectile goes extremely fast and the rate of fire is super quick and you can do a ton of damage in a short amount of time, even though each projectile doesn't do that much damage. I think it's around 14 to 15 at its base. Increasing the fire rate will make you do incredible things at close range, and because this is a laser weapon similar to one we saw in Advanced Warfare, your hip fire spread is basically non-existent. You can just hip fire your weapon if you didn't feel like aiming down sights and get the same result. Overall, a really cool weapon, and I cannot wait to use it in public matches once it goes live for everybody. Next up, I want to talk about the RA225. This is the brand new SMG that is coming through to the game as well. This has a high rate of fire and a super mobile compact frame. This allows your movement speed to be a little bit higher compared to other SMGs. And when you put other movements, forward attachments on these weapons, then you're going to be doing even better, obviously, if you want to just move really, really fast. The RA225, unfortunately, doesn't feel much different than other SMGs that we already have in the game. It never really did anything to surprise me other than having a little bit bonus movement speed, but beyond that, it's just not a weapon that I can really find myself gravitating towards versus other SMGs that exist in this game. And the most unfortunate part is, I was really hoping we wouldn't get another SMG. Part of me was really hoping that we'd get another shotgun. You know, we haven't had one this year in Vanguard, and I think it's because shotguns are always really controversial, but sticking with the theme of coming from the future, like they did with the EX1, I would have loved to see them add the Cell 3 cauterizer again. That was a shotgun from Advanced Warfare that was beautiful. It was definitely futuristic, and they could have went wild with the attachments this year. Or if they weren't going to go that route, it would have been cool to see them add the Model 1887 with an akimbo attachment. It would have been great to have that. Also, with the Terminator bundle, it would have been really cool to see those go together like they should have. But unfortunately, we got another SMG, which is a sad thing to say. I would have even accepted another marksman rifle at this point, and definitely another sniper rifle. It would have been cool to see that as well. The third and final weapon that's going to be coming through for Season 5 is the Valois Revolver. This is pretty much a gunblade. It's a melee weapon built into a revolver. This gives you the capability of having a one-hit melee while also providing 6 shots at your disposal with a few reloads at hand. Now, this particular revolver doesn't actually feature any attachments whatsoever. I really do feel like this is a missed opportunity on Sledgehammer's part to do some pretty fun, wacky, and wild stuff. Like, for example, maybe giving us an attachment to take it from a knife to a machete, giving us a little bit more range while still providing a one-hit kill. Dual wield would have been a really awesome and easy way to give us a little bit more damage coming at enemies. Giving players a way to convert the ammo type to maybe give us something like snake shots like we've seen in other weapons, and maybe even just giving us perks to allow us to move a little bit faster and upgrade that. That's the one thing I will say. This revolver allows you to run really, really fast, which is great, but the damage it does is abysmal. 3-shot kills to the body, 2 shots only if you hit him in the head, and at any range past medium, you're going to be doing 4 or more shots. It takes quite a bit of time to get a kill. This is definitely going to be one of those weapons that I use exclusively in hardcore in order to complete all the challenges. But overall, a very cool looking weapon. I just wish there was more done with it to give it a little bit more oomph in the battlefield. But overall, this is everything that's coming to Call of Duty Vanguard tomorrow. I think I'm most looking forward to the EX1. It's futuristic, it looks cool. I'm really curious how it's going to work in Warzone in particular. But with that said, I really thank you guys so much for coming out to this video here today. Let me know which weapon you're most interested in using tomorrow once Season 5 drops. And of course, if you enjoyed this video here, drop a like on it, subscribe for more videos coming every single day. And of course, if you haven't yet, don't forget to ring that bell icon, join the notification squad, and I will of course see you all on the next video. Peace.